Hello students, next we'll discuss very important topic in cryptography and network security is RSA algorithm. Okay, the RSA are the three scientists, okay, named Rivest, Shamir and Edelman. Okay, in 1977 they proposed a scheme using public key for encryption. Okay, you know, in converting from plain text to ciphertext, okay, is called encryption. Okay, so we use the public key there. Okay, and the corresponding private key for decryption. Okay, at the decryption and converting from ciphertext to plain text, okay, we use the private key. Okay, so clear, no? So this scheme is referred to as the RSA. Okay, so here, okay, for converting from plain text to ciphertext to, okay, use public key here, then converting from ciphertext to plain text, we use the private key here. Okay, so here the keys are different. Okay, so it is a asymmetric key. Okay, asymmetric key means what? Okay, at encryption end and decryption end, the keys are different. If keys are same, we say symmetric key, but here the keys are different. Okay, so here we use a symmetric key. So clear, no? Okay, so what is the use of this what are the applications of RSA? Okay, where RSA is used in encrypting and decrypting, then in digital signature and key exchange. Okay, we use RSA algorithm in encryption and decryption, digital signature and key exchange. Okay, these are the applications of RSA algorithm. Okay, let's see how to we'll take an example. Okay, what is the algorithm? Okay, and we'll take an example also, you can clearly understand. Okay, so here, okay, algorithm is there. Okay, it's the steps are there. Okay, what is the first step here? Okay, choose two large prime numbers. Okay, choose two large prime numbers P and Q. You have to take first two prime numbers. Then you have to find the product N equal to P into Q. Okay, that is referred to as the modulus. And pi of N is the Euler-Totient function. Pi of N is equal to P minus 1 into Q minus 1. Okay, so N is equal to P into Q. Pi of N is P minus 1 into Q minus 1. Clear, no? Okay, so here, can see here. So first select two prime numbers. Okay, then N is equal to P into Q, then pi of N is what? P minus 1 into Q minus 1. Clear, no? Okay, then after that choose encryption key E. Okay, you have to select encryption key E such that GCD of E pi of N, okay, is equal to 1. Okay, GCD of that E value, that encryption key value, and pi of N you will calculate, no, before that. Okay, and that GCD is must be equal to 1. Okay, the pair of integers E, that is E, and that N, P into Q N, okay, is referred to as public key. That is a public key. Okay, next you have to compute the decryption key. The decryption key is what? D. Okay, encryption key is called E, decryption key is called D. What is D here? D is equal to E inverse mod pi of N. Okay, D equal to E inverse. E will calculate here, no? Okay, E will calculate in step 2. Okay, in third step, you have to calculate D. Okay, so here you have to calculate D such way that E inverse mod pi of N. Okay, so here D is referred to as the private key here. Okay, so clear, no? Okay, then so clear, no? We'll take an example, then you can easily understand. Okay, so take an example. Okay, what is the first step? Choose two prime numbers P and Q. Okay, what is the prime numbers here? P is equal to 3, Q is equal to 11. Clear, no? Next, the product N equal to P into Q. The product N is equal to P into Q. 3 into 11 equal to 33. Clear, no? Then find the pi of N. What is pi of N? pi of n is equal to, okay, pi of n is what? P minus 1 into q minus 1. Clear, no? Okay. So, pi of n is equal to 3 minus 1, okay, and q minus 1, okay. That's equal to 20. Then, clear, no? Okay. Then, after the second step, in step 2, choose an encryption key E such that GCD of E, comma pi of n is equal to 1. Okay, you have to choose a encryption key E. Okay, there are two conditions for encryption key E here. One is E must be greater than 1 and less than pi of n. Okay, more than 1 and less than pi of n. Okay, and GCD of pi of n, comma E is equal to 1 here. Okay, so clear, no? So then here, see here, okay, 7 E is equal to 7 here. E is equal to 7 here. So 7 is more than 1 and less than 20. Okay, and GCD of 7 comma 20 is 1 here. Okay, 1 here, 7, that E value must be more than 1 and less than 20. Okay, and GCD is 7 comma 20 is 1 here. Okay, clear, no? Okay, you can find E value such that even you can select E is equal to 3 also. Okay, 3 is also less than 20 and more than 1, and GCD of 3 comma 20 is also 1 here. Okay, you can select 7 or you can select 3 also. Okay, then find D. Okay, D is equal to E inverse mod pi of n. Okay, what is D here? Okay, E inverse mod pi of n. Okay, let's see here. I will write here. Okay, D equal D E inverse. No, okay, you can write here. See here, D is equal to E inverse means you can write like this also. Okay, then mod pi of n. Correct, no? Okay, so D E equal to 1 mod. Okay, D is equal to 1 mod then 20 pi of n. Okay, so here you have to find such a number. Okay, you have to find such a number. Okay, that example here. So here you calculated E, no? What is E value here? 7. Okay, so D into 7, D into 7, okay, equal to 1 mod 20 here. D equal to 7, 1 mod 20 here. Okay, okay. So see here, if you divide by 20, okay, you have to find such number, you should get remainder 1. Okay, if you divide by 20, you should get remainder 1. Okay, so which number it is? Okay, so 17 is there. Okay, if you multiply with 3, you get 21 here. Clear, no? Okay, so 21 the 20. Okay, you get remainder 1. Okay, you have to find such number. Okay, so if you the remainder you should get 1. If you divide with 20, the remainder you should get 1. Clear, no? Okay, say even you can take 41 also. Okay, if you take 41, okay, divide by 20, okay, 22 the 40, remainder 1, like this. Even you can take 61 also, 81 also. Okay, so like this, you have to the remainder should get 1. Clear, no? Okay, so here you selected D is equal to 3 here. Okay, so here so E inverse, no? Okay, E into D, okay, equal to 1 mod pi of n. Okay, 7 into D, 7 you calculated, no? Into D. So now if you select D is equal to 3, you get 21 mod 20. Okay, 21 mod 20, you get remainder 1 here. Okay, then, so clear, no? 21 mod 20, you get 1. Okay, then, so D is equal to what? 3, no? So D is equal to 3 here. So what is the public key? What is the public key? Public key is what? Okay, so here, what is the public key? E comma N, no? Okay, E comma N is the public key here. Okay, so E comma N is the public key. So here public key is what? E comma N. E is equal to 7. E is equal to 7. And N is equal to 33. N is equal to 33. So E comma N is the public key. Clear, no? Okay. And what is the private key? Okay. D comma N. Private key is D comma N. Private key is D comma N. Okay. So, private key is D comma N. Okay. Here, private key is D comma N. Private key is D comma N. Public key is E comma N. Okay. So, here we calculated public key and private key. Okay. We'll take an example. Okay. How to do encryption. Okay. Your message, plain text, is 31. Your plain text, assume 31. Okay. We'll convert into ciphertext. Okay. So, how will convert into ciphertext to? Okay. So, here, ciphertext equal to M. M is the message. Okay. And M must be less than N. Okay. What is N? N is this value, 33. Okay. That must be less than N here. Okay. So, here, plain text M is less than that N value. N is P into Q. So, ciphertext is equal to M the power of P mod N. Okay, M is the message, plain text message. E is the, this E value. Okay, at key value. Okay. Then mod N. Clear, no? Okay. So, here we like take example. M is equal to 31, plain text. M is equal to 31, plain text. So, ciphertext is equal to, okay, 31 mod 31 power of 7. Here. M power of E. 31 power of E. E is equal to 7, no? E is equal to 7 here. E is equal to 7 here. 31 power of 7 mod 33. Okay. So, in last video, I explained how to find the remainder of a large number. Okay. Okay. I show you one example here. Here. See example, how to find 31 mod 33 here. 31 the power of 7 mod 33 here. Okay. What you have to do is, okay, it's a very large number. See, 31 power of 7 is this much big number. Okay. It's a little difficult to find it. Take more time to find the, okay, find the remainder of this. Very simple way I explain, no? 31 power of 7. 31 you multiply 7 times, you get this answer. Next, you have to divide with this 33. Okay. This 33. Then you get one number here after dividing this. Okay. You get some decimal point here. Okay. Then next step what you have to do is, you have to subtract this number, okay, with only integral part. Only integral part, only integer part. Okay, subtract this number, okay, this number minus this only integral part, no decimal point. Okay, only integral part. Then you get what? 0.12121. You get 0.12121. Okay. Then numerator integer part get 0. Okay, only fractional part is remain here. Then what you have to do, you just multiply with this number to this 33. Okay. You get the remainder. You get the remainder 4. Very easy, no? Okay. So you get what 4 here? Ciphertext 4. Okay. What is the plain text to? 31. What is the ciphertext to? 4 here. Okay. This is the equation to convert plain text to ciphertext. Okay. Then how to decrypt, how to decrypt, this is the ciphertext, how to get your plain text, okay, what is the plain text, how we get, okay, decryption, C the power of D mod N, okay, C is what, your ciphertext, power of D, D is what, D is the key, private key, okay, so D is the private key, okay, E is the public key, D is the private key. Okay, C the power of D mod N. Okay, what is C here? C is 4 here. Okay, you got 4, no? Then 4, what is D value? D value is 3. Okay, that private key, 3. 4 the power of 3 mod 33. What is 4 the power of 3? 64. 64 mod 33 is how much? 64 divided by 33. 64, 33 manza. Okay, you get 31. Okay, you get 31 here. Okay, so you get 31. Okay, that is the plain text. Correct, no? That is the plain text. Okay, the plain text is what? Plain 31 only. You get originally at the receiver end, you get plain text. there, no? Plain text converted to ciphertext. 4. Again, that ciphertext convert to plain text. You get same 31, 31 here. Okay. So here public key is 7, 33 and private key is 3, 33. So clear, no? Okay. Thank you.